Greetings. This is a second political video about the unicorn as a perfect example of liberal blindness. It is important because you need to understand the blindness and veil that covers the eyes of liberals. As you deal with people in these last days, you need to know they are not evil. They are blind, but rarely by their own choice. Years ago, there was a debate in the Congress on welfare reform. Google welfare reform Republicans alligators to do your own search. When I did, I found the following website, publiceye.org, and the banner says, Researching the Right for Progressive Changemakers, right in line with the other video I just made. I mention this website because it confirms the facts of what I am about to tell you. I also wrote this to the unicorn. When Republican lawmakers attempted to compare welfare programs that make people dependent with laws against feeding wildlife because it makes them dependent, the liberals, congressmen, press, talking points, all misrepresented the situation as Republicans call welfare recipients animals. So if you go to publiceye.org, you'll see that the debate was in 1995, and Representative John Micah of Florida demonstrated a sign, Do not feed the alligators. We post these warnings because unnatural feeding and artificial care creates dependency. That's the point he was making. The blind on the left miss a completely valid point in an honest intellectual discussion because they literally have no interest in or respect for the facts or the truth, which is the foundation of the solution to the problem. It is a perfect parallel for the way Mohammedans ignore facts, teaching, context, or any intelligent discussion. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Remember that. In these last days, you will have opportunity to get frustrated. But keep in mind, Satan blinds them so they cannot even hear. Do not be mad at them for being helpless and blind. Focus your righteous anger on Satan and be more loving and more patient. But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you. Now, I've presented the facts of the welfare animal dependency issue because it came up after I similarly tried to present an object lesson to the unicorn. The question of compromise is a tool liberals use to attack and dominate Christians. Compromise seems such a peaceful way to resolve a difference. But to be forced to make a compromise between two absolutely unacceptable alternatives is, one, a false choice, and two, the road to destruction. So, to help someone understand two unacceptable alternatives, I wrote the following story. An out-of-work liberal broke into a man's house late at night to satisfy his needs. The owner of the house stepped out with a gun and said, Stop, or I'll shoot. Clearly our tale is not in New York, where homeowners have no government-given right to life and self-defense. Whoa, said the liberal. I'm not here to hurt you. I'm just here to rape your wife and daughter. Take another step, and I shoot you dead. Okay, since killing is such an extreme thing, let's compromise. I'll only rape your wife or your daughter. You decide. and the liberal steps toward the man to shake hands on the compromise deal.
Bam!
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 The liberal falls dead. The police are called, an investigation occurs, and the homeowner is no-billed and released, a free man. The grand jury determines justifiable homicide. At the pearly gates, the dead liberal would-be rapist meets St. Peter. Your name is not in our book for today's arrivals. So how did your life end? It wasn't your time to die for many years. I apologize in advance for the profanity the liberal is about to use. I met a goddamned conservative who refused to compromise with me. The moral of our story is, when liberals offer you a choice of either raping your wife or your daughter, no compromise is acceptable. The only adult plan is to prepare for their inevitable attempt to rape your daughter and your wife. When liberals want a compromise on bankrupting America in 50 years or 100 years, no such compromise is acceptable. Hopefully, you understand the object lesson of being told you are forced to choose between a completely unacceptable demand and an equally unacceptable compromise. The unicorn read the story, and her reply was, "Your premise is liberals are rapists, but I'm sure you don't see that as pejorative." Completely like the welfare debate where liberals demonstrated an absolute inability to comprehend teaching examples that simplify the situation to where a child can grasp the concepts. And honestly, this is why America is doomed as a nation. Half the population has no interest in rational, intellectual discussion of the issues and solutions. And you can clearly see liberals are incapable of grasping basic object lessons. But you could bet your life, the liberals that watch this, if they make it this far, they will think Christians are the half who cannot. And that is the situation that damns this nation to collapse with nothing but finger-pointing to be offered. And I know they are conditioned to parrot that my comments are the finger-pointing, and that I am the hypocrite. As I stated in the prior related video, I've called this liberal a doorknob. I just can't help it, because they claim to be a Christian, but they have no light or life in them. But I know calling someone names does not win them to Christ. And I repent for not yet being perfected in the love of Christ. Jesus died for the unicorn, even though she is now actively researching to attack and destroy Christians and Christianity. Love the truth. Muslims, liberals, and others will fight you to get you to let go of the truth. But hold fast to the truth. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.